Back at it again. This time we're going to be building up the glue together model kit of Speed Racers Mach 5. Yes, you've seen me do the snap together one, a much more simple kit. This one's got full glue detail. It's got the saws. It's got the lifts. It's got an engine. It's got optional windshields. It's got water slide decals. So let's look at everything that'll be in the box when you get yours. You know what to expect. I will have this up for pre-order with the links in the description so you can get that ordered and it'll arrive this year. We got the nice ribbed tires on that side, plucked freshly off the tire tree. That's one of my running gags. These come right off the rubber tree, just like this. They have to clip them off. It's a hard job. They have to climb way up there. Nice ribbed pattern on those tires, like the cartoon. We've got two little screws in a bag. Don't lose those. Those hold the chassis to the body. We've got our standard windshield, optional windshield, and we got our lower lights on the kit. They are yellow. So if you want to replicate that, I will show you during the painting section how we're going, or the detail section, how we're going to get those to look like they do in the cartoon. We got an awesome chrome tree. This one's got full disc brakes, the nice looking wheels. It's got the saws. A lot of you saw the snap tight one. Well, I wish they wouldn't have taken out all those parts. They never did. Two different kits. Now you get to see both built. They got the knockoffs for the wheels, inner and outer part of the wheels. We got a mirror there. We got a shifter. We got all kinds of accessories going on. Both sides you can see. So that's pretty cool. And in this one, I love it because it's got water slides, which it'll make it a lot easier to get that big M on there, the 5. We got some extra Speed Racer emblems on there, all water slide decals. One of the little chrome parts fell off. It's that little cone that goes right on the passenger side. Goes right there. I still don't know what it's called. I really should look that up. I didn't know in the other review either, but that's okay. You don't have to know everything about a kit to build it and have a good time. We got our interior pieces here. This will be down in the engine bay. This is the interior of the Mach 5. All those holes are for mounting locations. Don't have to drill anything. Don't have to do any of that work. We got that awesome Mach 5 body. Looking sweet. Beautiful shape to that. The molds are holding up well. Nice and crisp. We got the bottom of the chassis. Of course, it's a high-tech streamlined racer, so we don't have a bunch of exhaust or transmission components hanging out the bottom. Just can see the suspension on either side. Nice and basic work. We've got our steering column and our feet to the lifts on either side. We've got the back cowl, like a Corvette would, off the back. We got seat belts in this one, seats, fins for the back. Nice looking machine. We've got those door panels. Basic detail on the door panel. Show you how to put a little bit of extra detail in them. Clutch pedal and gas, access hatch, steering wheel, cool little birdie. We got the top of the dashboard here, and we got the dashboard and the instrument cluster itself. I will detail that. You'll watch me do it. This is the curved area behind the seat. That little headrest we saw will go right in those two holes there. And this one's got all the cool parts. We got our engine, exhaust components. We got those lifts all the way across there, those feet. We got the extensions for the saw blades. We got all our little steering parts. It looks like we might have pulsable steering on this thing. We got our rear axle there. These are the little extensions that those metal saw blades will mount onto. We can put them on there, mount them off the front of the car, have it look like it's all in cartoon mode. And that is it. That's all the parts. Not a ton of them, but enough to make a sweet looking Mach 5. I'm going to get the glue and mine together. I'll be right back. All right. All ready for the sub-assembly. This kit is kind of half snap tight, half glue. It's got more features than the other kit, so we'll go over those. On the body underneath, I have the little access hatch here taped on from the bottom so that I can get it painted with the body so that it lines up and everything looks nice. On the body itself, on this one, the rear hatch will open so that we'll be able to see the engine underneath there because it has full engine detail. That's just held in place with a hinge mechanism. And in the instructions, you can see these parts here where the body would normally clip on the snap tight. They have you cut those parts off so that you can have the hood open and the nicely detailed engine will be seen. We've got the wheels pressed together. It's just a friction fit with three pins on the inside. Those won't need any work. The only thing that we'll be detailing behind the wheels is I will go in and hand paint the calipers, black wash the rotors, and then I will black wash the centers of the knockoffs to get that M logo, that Mach logo highlighted. And then we'll do some work around the saw blades and stuff like that. We'll make them look nice before we install it. This will be the deluxe version of Mach 5. On the interior, the door panels can stay as they are for now. I put the headrest on and the back. According to the box art, that should all be red, so I will be detailing that, and I like that red interior. These are sides of the engine and smaller parts, so I cut that tree off, and now I can detail those with their own metallic colors. I'm going to be doing my own designs for the inside of the engine bay. I couldn't really find anything online. Now, there is a picture of whomever built the box art for them, where they did the engine in certain colors, but I'm going to go in and detail it my own way. It's my Mach 5. When they pop the hood, I want to see what I want to see underneath there. We're going to do the seats in place. We'll primer all this. I'm going to get this interior engine bay painted in one color. And as you can see, most of the engine bay components are going to be a large press fit or super glued in place. So there's no reason to worry about that. That's all set the way it is. We'll get that detailed. We got the feet here. Now, this Mach 5, since it has all those extra features in the snap kit that I already built, doesn't, and that looks beautiful just as a closed up car. Mine, I'm going to be doing with the legs down, with the saws out, with the hood, that's a hood brace, by the way, with the hood braced open. So that's how I want to do this one. So we're going to be doing it a little different. These are the feet you could put into the bottom of the chassis if you didn't want to use those jacks. So since I'm using them, I'm just going to throw them to the side. I don't need them. We've got the bird here. Now, I will be following the box art. That's painted a chrome color, so I'll be painting that, so that will sit underneath there. This is something on top of the engine, might be a nitrous bottle, might whatever it wants to be. I'll be painting that with the engine components. We got our seat belt. You could do those in a nice black, red, orange, whatever you wanted. I'll be painting them up my way. We've got engine parts here and exhaust. On the same tree, I want to get those painted up a beautiful metallic color. The bottom of the chassis, I've got the axle glued in. I've got the front support for the front steering. If you want, you can hook up the steering to actually work with the steering wheel. I am going to leave mine posable, but I won't be hooking up the final parts to make it work with the steering wheel. I had some issues with the steering wheel and the steering wheel mount lining up properly, so I just kind of glued those solidly in place so you can see all that together. There is no decal for the dashboard, so I will be accentuating the little TV screen and kind of leaving the dash gauges hidden back there. There's your steering mechanism if you were to make it work. That's glued in place. Just before I put mine in, I will be cutting that off. We won't be able to see that through there anyways, and I didn't set it up so that it would function with the steering. But I want you to see how it would look if you glued it all together. I am ready to head to paint. Got the interior ready to go. Got the body. The fins just press in. And then I just dabbed a little bit of glue, but they do snap in anyways. I just put a glue to kind of seal up that seam where those spoilers do go through there. Those look great. They line up nicely. They key in themselves. No issues. I'm going to throw paint at all of this, and then we'll come back for the details.
Thank you. Thank you.
just going to wrap things up in a little bit. We can see all the parts before I get all the final stuff so you can get a good look. We got that sweet wheel and tire package with the little M logo that I blackwashed inside there. Check out these brake rotors and calipers. Those will be going on the back of the wheels. We'll get those pressed onto the axles. We got those nice yellow lenses. You see that Tamiya clear yellow? Looks awesome on there. Gets us that nice tint. Just brushed on, left to dry. And if you brush it on the inside, the outside will be super glossy and smooth. We've got the little landing gear, the little lift feet, blackwashed, all set to go. Got the saw blades assembled. Those are so cool, so I can't wait to display this as the operational one, looking all awesome. Got to put my decals on. I'll be using the red, the big M, and the 5. The speed racers are just extras. You can put those wherever you want. I'm not putting them on the body, but you could put them on your little display or anything that you did. And then the chassis, and of course, it looks so much like a Formula One race car. Awesome looking. Check out the engine detail on this one that we don't have on the Snaptite. This is actually the hood prop. I'm not sure how well that's going to work, but that's just a loose part, so I wanted to show it in place. We got all that engine detail blackwash. That interior of the cockpit looks awesome with the belts, and you can see how easily using that gloss two-tones our interior for us. Almost like I used two different shades of red, but I didn't, with a little bit of washing in there, and then the awesome details on the dashboard. And everything, got the mirror in place. That gray paint on the bottom brings out the details of the bottom of the chassis, and I've got the headlights glued in the front, and then we'll be putting those yellow lenses on top of the body there. The windshield is just loosely placed in. I'll put that in at the end. You see I did black around the edge so that when it's in place, it almost looks like gasket material all the way around there. And then I used that gray liner pencil to give our panel lines some accent, just enough to stick out. I didn't want to use black, I just used gray, so it's not a complete wash through like that. And we are all set to go. That's it. Not a whole lot of work involved in this one, just a little bit more than the snap kit, but it gives us a lot more detail. So I'm going to push everything together, use the little screws right there to hold it all steady. The screws should go in there and there. And then I will be done with the kit and be right back. From top to bottom, the Polar Lights 125th scale glue together Mach 5 is a much more detailed model than the snap together. Now they both end up the same size. They look beautiful. They have great interiors. And with this version, you get water slide decals, which are much easier to work with, in my opinion, than stickers on a shape like this where they have to conform to the doors and the nose and the taillights and everything. And you get an opening bonnet, you get the lift feet, and you get the saws off the front. All right, you get a full engine detail. I didn't compare the two. I think you might even get a little bit more detailed interior, but I don't want to be quoted on that. You get the little door that opens for the little flying bird thing underneath there, and it all goes together super nice. Of course, you can build it one of two ways with that larger windshield cowl, or as I did it right from the cartoons that I like, and it all goes together super easy. The only thing is that at the end, pressing in the feet and the blades in the front can be a little stiff. You might have to take your X-Acto knife and whittle out the holes and open it up and get it ready. But when you're done, it looks really awesome. The hood raises up, the prop rod fits right in and holds that like that. And you've got a lot more detail than I thought was going to be in the glue kit when I heard they were releasing it. So I'm going to display this one with the engine open, the feet down, the saw blades out, and I can have it right next to my other Mach 5 with it all closed up, and we can just see the interior, and you don't have to mix and match and do the other ones. You can see underneath, I'll probably lose my prop rod when I tilt it, but it looks like the other one underneath, and you do have the option, of course, of just putting in the other feet so that it doesn't sit on those at all and there's no holes at the bottom, and you don't have to attach the saw blades, and you could have it be the street version. I like it all lifted up like they're working on it. They got the hood open. I detailed the engine the way I felt like it should be detailed. Also, a little tip about final assembly. Locate the engine and underhood area into the body so that you can fit the exhaust through the holes and then press it onto the chassis. You can put the interior in after that and you'll be all fine. If you try to attach the engine and under the hood area to the chassis like I had it at first, you're not going to get the body on because those exhausts have to go through the back of the body. But otherwise, super easy build. I love that it's got opening accessories. You can look inside, you can check it out, you can see how it works and stuff like that, like the cartoon, and you could remove all that and display it as the car racer. So thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over for a review. I will link down to where you can get this on pre-order if it's not available yet. I'll have the links in the description. As always, build your Mach 5 the way you want to see it. You want to do a custom Mach 5 and get it set up with a blue interior and an orange body or whatever the heck you want. Build it your way so that you can smile and have fun. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks for the support of our awesome sponsors and your encouraging comments and questions and your likes and shares of the videos whenever you feel like it. We'll see all of you at the next review. Thank you.